for who you are, for what you have given us, and for what you have done unto us, individually and corporately. And now, Heavenly Father, we are ready so that we can feed our heart with the bread of life, as well as you quench our thirst with the waters of life. I pray that you speak to us in the language that we are going to understand as you explain your word to us, and continue speaking to us in the voice that all of us are going to hear your word this morning. Guide me as you speak to your people. Use me like your vessel as well as you speak to me. This we pray in the name of Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Have mercy. Praise the Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I once again take this wonderful opportunity to continue welcoming you in our service this day. Today, as we stated the last 2 weeks, it is a Thanksgiving service, and today we have the Holy Communion. Last Sunday, I indicated that we need to come with our children. Na siwa kusahabu kati nimesahabu kubayena class in Sunday school. Anna, I know we would like to have a fellowship as we pray for all of us so that we receive the blessings of the Lord together. Kindly, the children remain in our service, but coming Sunday, personally, I will be with you in our Sunday school classes. So coming Sunday, children, I will be your teacher in our Sunday school classes together with other Sunday school teachers. I greet you in the name of Jesus Christ. When I see you, my joy coming up now and then. Paul could see, when he could see his people, that you are my joy. When I see you coming back to our worship place, I feel that my joy is getting full now and then. Thank you very much, Baba Askofu Gideon, for taking this opportunity. Despite the age, you have said, I will must come. Thank you very much. Mom, Isaac, thank you very much for coming. And all of us for taking your time to come and fellowship with us. So, I don't take this for granted. I praise the Lord because of each and one of you. May the Lord continue blessing me. May the Lord continue intervening and fighting for each and every one of us. I also could see Mama Esther there. Mama Esther, how are you? Thank you very much, Mom, for even supporting us. Since the day we received to the church, you said I'll be coming in support of our Christian and in an assurance that God is able and is doing for all of us. So thank you very much, all of you. Feel that you're most welcome as we worship. Yes, this week I was evaluating the schedule of our services when we are coming. And I did the last 3 Sundays, and I could see the number of our church is getting up and up and up and up. Last Sunday but one, we were 62. Last Sunday but two, we were 62. Last Sunday, here again, we were 72. Last Sunday, we were 84. Today, I believe we are ready. Praise God. So, karibuni sana, as we go out, let us continue mobilizing, reminding our Christians, calling them, telling them, Kanisa kibibuni. Praise the Lord. As I do my part as a vicar, join me as we mobilize to others so that they can come back ili tuweze kubarikiwa tukiwa pamoja. As you are aware, today is a Thanksgiving service. We have read from our readings from the book of Psalms 103, and also we read from the book of Philippians chapter 4, where Paul was reminding the Philippians that in all circumstances they need to be thankful and grateful to God. Not in a specific situation or circumstances or situation, but Paul could tell them, after you pray, after you bring your prayers to the Lord, you need to be thankful to God in all situations. If you read from Psalm 40, you could see when David, he said that he waited patiently to the Lord, and the Lord hearkened his prayer and answered them. He could thank God in that midst of challenges and problems. David could thank God because of what the Lord had done to him and given him, and who was the Lord to King David by that line. Where we have read today in the book of Psalms 103, it is a climax of what we have been doing for the last two Sundays. We have been counting our blessings one by one. I concur with my brother. I call him my brother Peter. There's one day he said a history of a song, this by name, Count Your Blessings One by One. And also we keep on singing that song, Count Your Blessings One by One, and maybe you could be surprised to see what the Lord has done for you. And you could count, the blessings could be countless. They could be as many as we continue counting them. This morning I was telling the people from Kiswahili service that starting with us, breath of life, that you could see, that you could communicate, that you could hear, that you could do A, B, C, D, it is one of the blessings that we can count that we have received from our Lord. And so, brethren, today it is our day to say thank you to the Lord. When we flash back from January to now, when we have seen what the Lord has done to all of us corporately and individually, we have the cause to thank God. In the response to that call, today we are coming to say thank you to the Lord. For the Christian, giving thanks to God is a response to goodness and mercies that we have received from our God. It is also a mark of obedience because we are commanded by God to give thanks. And God knows when we give thanks, it is good for our own relationship with Him and for our own well-being. So, brethren, to give thanks, it is a response to the goodness that individually and corporately we have received from the Lord. It is a response to the mercies of the Lord. We are looking out for the grace and mercies of the Lord. Surely, akugafika mahali tumefika. And so, it is a command, God commanding us, that we need to continue giving Him thanks. In the book of Thessalonians, chapter 5, go and read. Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16 and verse 18. It teaches that we should give thanks to God in all circumstances. For this is the reason, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for all of us. So, in all circumstances, we need to be thankful to God. In all situations, in up and down, we need to be thankful to God. And so, men, we need to flash back where we have come from. We need to have a personal or a corporate evaluation. And after all this, maybe from January to today, from where the first case of COVID-19 was announced in Kenya, we need to flash back from that time to date, and surely we can see or will see the goodness of our God, how merciful our God has been to each and every one of us, corporately and individually. And we are going to see how generous our God and how kind He has been to us throughout the year. And so, we can concur with this man, David, who could say, "My heart, forget not the goodness of God,
the goodness of Almighty God, who healed your disease, who took care of you, who redeemed your life, who crowned your youth with compassion and love, who satisfied you with good deeds. We can conquer with God, with David, because of all that we have experienced from God. And so, brethren, it is our cause to say thank you to our God. We are to be thankful, brethren, for the things we are not to be thankful for the things that only we like, but also we are supposed to be thankful to God even for the things that we don't like. We are going to see the reason why. When we purpose as a Christian to thank God for everything He allowed us to come through or to come on our life, we keep bitterness at bay, since no way we can come before the Lord with both thankfulness and bitterness at the same time. So, thanking God will help our bitterness. Maybe what we have been passing through and the kind of the bitterness we have been experiencing while passing through what we are passing through, thanking God will help you and I to keep that bitterness away. We do not thank God for evil, but we thank Him for sustaining us through that. He sustained us through. There are so many things that we can say, this is the evil, be it a sickness, be it an accident, be it, you can count them. But we do not thank God because of that evil, but we thank Him for helping us and sustaining us. And that is why we can say, surely I am more than conqueror because of this God. We do not thank God because of the harm He did not cause to us, but we thank Him because of the strength He gave us to overcome that evil, to overcome that struggle, to overcome that challenge. We give God thanks because of the strength that He gave us to overcome and to endure that. Brethren, we give thanks to God because of His promises. He said, all things will work together for the good to those who love Him, to those who loved Him and are called according to His purpose. So, we need to thank God because of the call that He had called us with. When we re-evaluate ourselves, when we examine ourselves and see what we have been passing through, in all circumstances, we need to thank God. Brethren, why then should we give thanks? Why then should we give thanks? When counting our blessings, we need to be sure to give God thanks because of what He has done to you and because of who He is in your life. If you read that Psalms 103, you could see King David saying, who redeemed? So, to King David, God is his redeemer. He redeems. He is his healer. He forgives. To King David, God, he is satisfied. To King David, God, he knew. So, he could thank God because of who God is in his life. We need to be thankful to God because of what He has done and because of who He is in our life. Two or three things, so that I miss it. One reason to give God thanks is for what He has given us. And that is why we say, count your blessings one by one. Because of what He has given you individually or corporately, in what God has given us, we need to count His unconditional love. His unconditional love. His sufficient grace. All through, He keeps on renewing His mercies, His grace to you day by day. He's given you victory in a different way in Jesus Christ. He has blessed you materially, spiritually, health-wise. He continued giving you good health. In your job, He continued blessing you. He continued blessing your family. No one of us who can stand and say, I'm not blessed for the Lord. All of us, we can say that we are blessed, be it in our family, be it in our job, be it through our children, we are blessed. We are blessed by God, by giving us loving and caring spouses, loving and caring children, loving and caring parents. We need to give God thanks because of many things that He has given us. Number two, we need to be thankful to God for what He has done to you and to me. What the Lord has done. I keep on singing this song, that what the Lord has done to me, I cannot tell it all. That what the Lord has done to me, I cannot tell it all. Ametenda maajabu na siwezi kueleza, siwezi kueleza, siwezi kueleza. Ametenda maajabu na siwezi kueleza. Ametenda maajabu. That what the Lord has done unto me and unto your life, surely we cannot tell it all. So we need to keep God thanks because of what He has done to us individually and corporately. In Psalms 118 and verse 21, Psalms 118 and verse 21, David could be thankful to God because He answered his prayer and it became his salvation. Together with us, we need to be thankful to God, for He has answered our prayer. We have been in prayer since the closure of the churches. And the Lord has done it in us. He had answered our prayer. He had become our salvation. We need to be thankful to God because He has done in our life what He redeemed our life, that we are not infected, even though we may be affected in one way or another. Our businesses are affected by this economy, by this COVID-19, but we are not infected. He redeemed us from that. God had redeemed you and I from a different places or in situations or circumstances. He also redeemed us that while we are still a sinner, He gave us His only Son, Jesus Christ, to come and die for us. Whatever He has done to us, He had qualified us to share in or to be an inheritor of the kingdom of God. And lastly, we need to give God thanks for who He is in our life. We need to give God thanks for who He is in our life. His love endures forever. If you read many Psalms, Psalms 117, Psalms 118, you could see, let us give God thanks because His love endures forever. When you turn east, west, up, down, north, west, north, south, you could see how the love of God is. The love of God endures forever. We need to give God, because of who He is faithful and just to us. Brethren, When we train our hearts to be thankful, when we train our heart to be thankful, we do many good things to ourselves, to our heart. It gives credit when credit is due. It keeps us from bitterness. Thanking to God, thanksgiving to God, it keeps us from bitterness and discouragement. When we give God thanks, it protects us from letting our life to be defined by what we do not or we don't have. It keeps us humble. It helps us to be humble ourselves and remind us of our needs for God. It reminds us of our needs for God. Brethren, let us train our heart to be thankful to God in season and out of season. Gracious Father, we want to thank you for that opportunity. We want to honor your holy name for being with us and for reminding us that we need to be grateful and thankful to you all the days of our life. Help us to be thankful to you. Help us to continue counting many blessings. Help us to continue acknowledging you in our life. In the name of God the Father.